Hi, my name is Caroline Fielding and I'm librarian at Charles and Part Academy Special School. I'm currently the chair of Youth Libraries Group London Committee and I was a Carnegie Kate Greenaway judge a few years ago. Today I'm going to share with you a Fielding family favourite. If you've watched any of the other National Shelf Service videos, you'll know that there's a huge range of titles available as ebooks from your local library authority for young adults and older children. But you can find quite a collection of picture books to share with younger children, toddlers and babies too. So, as far as I'm concerned, these younger picture books should be read by everyone of any age, and the very best picture books can be read over and over and over again until you know them by heart but still love them. You Must Bring a Hat, with words by Simon Phillip and illustrations by Kate Hindley, is a great example of such a book. B is nearly 5 years old now, and this has been a favourite for more than three of those years. Thanks to this book, one of her first words was monocle, but to find out why, you'll have to read it. Our narrator receives an invitation to a party, the biggest, hattiest party of all time, and there is one key instruction: you must bring a hat. But can they find a hat? Eventually they do. But when they get to the party, the bouncer tells them there are other rules too. Each page has lots to look at, with a fabulous supporting cast just happening to stroll down the street at the right moment to help with the increasingly ridiculous rules as our central character gets more and more frustrated. But do they make it into the party? You'll find out. Obviously, an important part of sharing a picture book is doing the voices. I call it a Fielding family favourite and not just one of B's favourites, because all three of us read it together nearly every time. My husband reads the narrator, I read the bouncer and the badger voices, and B is the monkey. Spoiler, the monkey has one line and that line is no. To help with this, each character's dialogue is written in a different font, so you don't need to have practiced quite as many times as we have to do it well. I chose this book as, having read it approximately 7,000 times, it still makes us laugh on every single reading. This book is great to read aloud, surprising and hilarious. I hope you enjoy You Must Bring a Hat, but if it isn't available in your authority, then do have a look for something else written by Simon Phillip or illustrated by Kate Hindley, because they've both worked on some brilliant books. Bye.